Returning on Talkback after he's become the Minister of State in the Communications Ministry is Sachin Pilot. Sachin Pilot, welcome to Talkback once again.
Thank you very much.
And congratulations. We're meeting for the first time after your victory.
Congratulations
on a big victory.
Thank you for having me back on the program.
Okay, let me then begin by asking you one of the big things that we have heard. Over the years, we've always believed that Minister of State doesn't really mean anything. They're junior ministers. Essentially, you spend 5 years learning about the genre of work that you're entrusted with because there's a senior minister doing all the policy decisions. This time, there are many new things, and including one of the things that is new seems to be the Prime Minister's great focus to say junior ministers must get work. So divide up the work, tell them exactly what sphere they will be taking participating in and what are their achievable goals, not just in 100 days, but across the 5 years. What will be your area or genre of focus in the ministry that you've participated in?
Look, we have a ministry here and there are three of us are working here. We have two ministers of state and we have a cabinet minister. Now, I think all policy decisions that happen in the cabinet. So it is the Prime Minister and whose team we are a member of. And I think we all work collectively, irrespective of the designation, what it is, because we're all members of the Union Council of Ministers. And there is separate work allocation done for all ministers of state who work under the Cabinet Ministry and the Cabinet Minister. So I think the idea is really to work together to be able to give the best policies that we can to the people of this country. And I am looking after the Ministry of IT and Communications along with my colleague and the Cabinet Minister. So I think we're all working in tandem with each other.
But in that, isn't there, from what we hear, in that also there are concrete divisions saying, okay, you focus on this aspect, I'll focus on this aspect, if it indeed is two ministers of state and the senior minister.
I think it works best that way, that you know you have some division of labour.
So what is your, what but will be your genre?
I'm focusing on the information technology part of the ministry.
Right.
But it's not to say that the other minister will, you know, are not, is not part of the decision-making process.
No,
so
not at all.
We all work as a team.
Sure.
And I think we pay sometimes too much attention, too much focus on exactly the commas and the T's and the dotting of the I's. What is more important is that what are we coming out, what are the programs that we are initiating, what are the policy frameworks that we are forming, what is the road ahead for the ministry, what are we going to be able to achieve, and how is the life of the Indian citizen going to get better through this ministry. That is the objective of the exercise.
Okay, that's exactly what we'll come to. But before that, in some senses, the reason why we are focusing on exact duties is because in the past in India, what has happened is everything remains in a sort of generic blame game.
The government is working as a collective entity.
Sure.
And whatever decisions the cabinet makes, it's a decision of the cabinet of this country. It's a collective decision. And all other parts of the government are working in tandem, in close cooperation with each other.
Sure.
And we are working as ministers appointed by the Prime Minister.
Sure.
So I think overemphasis on exactly who's handling which part of the ministry, which work, you know, it's all okay in terms of the working of the ministry. But all decisions are collective. It's not a minister's decision, any policy decision. It goes to the cabinet, gets approved there, and that's when it gets implemented.
Okay, so you are, from what I understand, going to focus on the IT part of the ministry. In that sense, what would be your first three agendas, if I may say so, in the next 100 days? What are the key ideas that you would want to work with?
Look, I've always believed that information technology has been, in the last two decades, a great source of not just foreign earnings and employment in this country, but also in a time like this when we are facing economic slowdown across the world. This is a great tool for us to be able to combat that. And the IT sector has been a net employer in the last 1 year compared to other sectors where there have been layoffs and, you know, job losses. So I see great potential. And for me, I think the most important thing is to be able to deliver information technology to every single Indian citizen, no matter where he or she lives and what community they belong to and what strata of society they are from. So to be able to make technology and information readily available in a fashion that's easily palatable.
And one also, big idea, how you'll do that?
Well, I think we have programs already in progress. We have the National E-Governance Program that is going to really lay the bedrock for kind of creating a network of national and state highways of information so that we are able to disseminate information more cheaply, efficiently, and it breaks barriers of region and, you know, some parts of our society which have not been so far included in the information technology revolution. So that's one. The other is actually to be able to give services through service centers that we are coming up with. So the plan is to have 100,000 service centers across the country. So there's 600,000 villages. On every six villages, there should be one center. We have about 40,000 of them up and running. This is a PPP model. So you have an entrepreneur in the village who's able to provide services. And here, I think an important part of this is that illiteracy or lack of computer education is not an impediment for people to be able to access those services.
Sure.
Because it's assisted by the person who runs these centers. And they can give a lot of these services, whether it's birth certificates, land records, NREGA documents that are required, certification for which you and I both know in rural India to get certified, to get attested, to get patwari, collector, administration, bureaucrats. It's very tedious, time-consuming, and expensive process in most cases. So this can really cut out all of that. Also create employment in the area. That's what I think is the most important part of what I'm going to be doing. People in larger cities, in tier one cities, have the access and the resources to get hold of technology and make their lives better. We have to be able to translate this into the rural areas.